Thank you for joining us on SAP Developer News, where our developer advocates will get you up to speed with some great information.
The latest features as part of the ABAP environment release 2111 are now available. The functionalities of the wrap generator is now supported by the ABAP development tools in Eclipse through the Generate Repository Object wizard. This means that you can use Eclipse and a wizard-based approach to leverage capabilities of the already known wrap generator to generate the whole stack of wrap application based on a database table. There's also a new Fiori app called Display Security Audit Log as part of the SAP Fiori Launchpad of the ABAP environment system. This app makes information about security relevant events in the system transparent, which supports you in case of audits. To learn more about the latest features, read Florian's blog post where he shares an overview of the new release.
SAP's newest visual theme, Horizon, was recently introduced at SAP TechEd and is part of the new design language, is an evolution of SAP Fiori. It focuses even more strongly on helping people get their work done faster, more easily, and with better outcomes. With its bold typography and modern design, it looks very intuitive and effortless, but friendly at the same time. As a developer, you can already try out the experimental preview and see it for yourself, for example, with the latest versions of SAP UI5. S4HANA Cloud 2.1.1 customers can even register to give feedback and help fine-tune Horizon even further. Another interesting evolution in the UI world is the support of TypeScript for SAP UI5. At SAP TechEd, we had Wouter Lemire on Channel 1 to talk about his experience with TypeScript in SAP UI5 and how he now uses it whenever possible in his development projects. It helps him to catch bugs earlier and be more efficient altogether. Wouter has published a great blog post series about this, which is definitely worth checking out.
More documentation has been made part of the Open Documentation Initiative. In addition to the documentation for the SAP Business Application Studio, the SAP Private Link Service, the Administration Guide for SAP S4HANA Cloud for Advanced Financial Closing, and the Contribution Guidelines themselves, we now have the core SAP Business Technology Platform documentation, as well as the Best Practices Guide for SAP BTP in there too. Find out more from this blog post from Nicola and start collaborating with us.
As an application developer for the SAP BTP Cloud Foundry runtime, you had to rely on HTTP 1.1 protocol, but now it is possible to use HTTP 2 protocol as well. Two use cases are particularly targeted, which are, first, improvement of performance for client-centric architectures, which may send many parallel HTTP requests to the backend. This can be solved through the use of HTTP 2 multiplexing, which is supported by almost all modern browsers. And second, HTTP 2 is a dependency for many modern frameworks like gRPC. So the support for HTTP 2 protocol on SAP BTP Cloud Foundry runtime got shipped with the November 18th release of this year. For more information and how to use HTTP 2 with the Cloud Foundry load balancer and your application, go to the website posted in this video's description.
SAP UI5 Chief Architect Peter Müßig released a fantastic blog post shortly before TechEd. I want to recap it here briefly to bring it to your attention in case you missed it because of all the other big announcements. He explained an easy way to integrate any open source library into your UI5 project using TypeScript. There has already been a similar blog post roughly a year back. Project shims using NPM modules with UI5 that does something similar. But Peter went one step further and combined the project shims with TypeScript to get code completion support for these NPM packages as well. For this, he developed a UI5 tooling extension that makes it possible to include any NPM package with close to zero configuration in UI5 applications just by using the NPM package as a runtime dependency. You can learn more about this in the linked blog post, in a video published during the final week of Devtoberfest, or in the most recent UI5ers Live. And one more news item for the Mac OS developers who already were brave enough to update to Mac OS Monterey. Apple changed the default port of the AirPlay receiver to 5000, which is, as you probably know, the port that the app router uses by default as well. To summarize it shortly, there are two options for you. Either you disable the AirPlay receiver to free port 5000, or you specify the port the app router should listen to via the environment variable. Instructions for both options can be found in the linked Twitter conversation, which was brought to my attention by an alert Twitter user. Thanks a lot for this.
SAP TechEd may be over for this year, but the learning still continues. The developer keynote and the deep dive discussion that followed directly after it is available for replay on the SAP Developers YouTube channel. What's more, we're starting to create follow-up content based upon the sessions that we showed. For example, there's already a two-part blog post series on the BTP CLI, specifically looking at the BTP GUID script and parsing strategies for plain text output and JSON output. Find out more on the SAP community website.